miss you guys, and we hope you're doing well and having some fun at home. Callie is going to be my assistant today, and we're looking forward to spending a little time with you doing some art. So let's get started. The first thing I want to go over is just to make sure you have all the supplies you need. So you're going to need a black Sharpie, some colored Sharpies. You're going to need some tape of some kind. If you have washi tape laying around, that's kind of fun tape with colors. That's great. If not, I love painter's tape. And of course, if you have none of those, just general Scotch tape will work as well. You need a pair of scissors, you need aluminum foil, and you need a box, either a cracker box or a cereal box of some kind. Any size box will do. And then lastly, if you have some puff paint or glitter glue laying around, you can use that at the very end, okay? All right, lastly, as we get going here, you may want to pause the video just to catch up with us. That's totally fine. Please pause the video as you need to so that you can stay with us and do your best work. All right, let's get started. So the first thing you're going to need to do is take a box of some sort. We're going to use this cracker box today. And you are going to cut the box. So I am going to cut maybe down the side. I'm trying to get a square piece. You're trying to get a square piece of cardboard, basically. So it doesn't have to be perfect, but you do want it to look somewhat square. So I cut off a piece like this, and I'm probably going to cut off the bottom down here.
Yes.
I don't want the flat part. Okay. I can also cut off, I'll have Kelly cut off the other side of the box so you can see. You can cut, boxes can come in any size. We had a cracker box we cut, and that created a square piece for us. And there's some rectangular pieces. I thought in the end these could make some great bookmarks. So any size of box will do, okay? All right, so once you've cut your box, you are going to need some aluminum foil. And you're gonna tear off a piece of aluminum foil because you're gonna wrap it around the cardboard. You can wrap it all the way around, or you can use the tape. So we're gonna show you how to do that. So I'm gonna take a piece off, and I'm gonna lay my box over here. I'm gonna move some of my tape and puff paint out of the way for later. I'm gonna take my box that I just cut, and I'm not actually gonna see either side of the box. I'm gonna lay it in the middle of the aluminum foil, and I'm gonna start wrapping it like I would have cut it. I need to just pull square ones. So just like that, I'm just wrapping it like a pen. So you're going to need a few little pieces just on the inside just to kind of hold it down. Like I said, any tape works. You could use just regular old Scotch tape like this. It's clear. It's totally fine. The painter's tape, once again, I love painter's tape, works great. You're just holding down the tin foil. Okay. What you wanna make sure is that the front part looks nice and smooth and flat. That's what you really want. So go ahead and tape down your aluminum foil in the back. And then once you do that, you are also gonna wanna secure the sides, because that could be maybe where the corners would rip. And it also just kind of creates a frame around your cardboard. So you're going to kind of measure it out with your hands and then tear your tape. If you have to use multiple pieces, it doesn't matter. That could also look fun if you did, you know, you want to do many different pieces around the side. So I put it half on and half off, and then you just fold it around to secure the edges of your, like that. So we're going to do it on all four sides. Like I said, if we're going too fast for you, please go ahead and pause the video. you doing, Kelly?
I'm doing good. I'm taking a bit too much tape, but then I'm folding it across, so, you know.
On the back side?
Yep, see? Because I'm like folding it, but then I always have like a little extra tape on the side, so okay. I'm like folding it.
Yeah, you could also cut it off, right?
Yep.
So I did that too right here. This tape is so easy to tear too. Sometimes you can just tear the edges off like that, so it's nice and even.
That was probably my worst one.
And like I said, you could use different ones, so we could switch and, you know, change which one we're using if we wanted to make more. If you had a bunch of different washi tapes, because they're pretty fun.
Yep. I have a lot of washi tapes in my room, and they are all like, I have like flowers, I have like black and white. They're all really, really fun.
They're really kind of fun to use. So, lots of good activities with washi tape. All right, so then you have your little thing and it's all framed and you're ready to go. But first you're gonna need your black marker and we're just gonna doodle. So I'm hopefully gonna put some music on here for you and I just want you to do a doodle. Any doodle with a black line. You're not really coloring in, you are really just seeing where your pen takes you. So go ahead and just do some doodling. Good doodle, Callie. Really good doodle.
I did a really big one.
You did a very big one.
That was a really bad heart.
And your doodle might have curvy lines. It also might have a lot of straight lines and
like
edges.
Mine has a lot
like
of curvy.
Mine has kind of a variety.
Mine has a lot of curvy lines.
You just have fun with it however you want. All right, when you're done with your doodle, so your doodle can look like anything. Let's see your doodle, Callie. You don't want to add too many details in the middle yet. So then you're going to take your colored markers and you are going to color your doodle. So we're going to spend a couple minutes coloring.
I'm going to take this color. I like it.
The more detail you provide, the more fun and interesting your picture is going to be. And believe it or not, yellow shows up really well on the
tin foil. I thought it showed up like gold, so you might want to show that.
It does show up really well. So I'm going to try and use some of these colors so that you can see what they look like.
See, like the pink turns out like that. It's really awesome.
So before I go any further, what I wanted to show you too is the details with the black marker are awesome, but it's better to color in first. So color in and then you can add, you know, any sort of dots or lines or whatever you think would be fun with the black pen over. So if that makes sense, I did it right here. You can see all those little details. So color in first the big areas and then add your details.
On the yellow road, and he either can take the lava away where he dies, Or you can take the chest waver and get some chest stuff.
Oh, wow, I like this. So this here is lava.
That's lava, and that's just grass. But I was trying to do, like, something.
I hope he stays on the grass.
Yeah, totally.
So it's really fun what you can come up with your own doodles. You might even have a story behind it, which would be fun. Okay, so we're going to show you now how you can add some details. We actually paused the camera to finish coloring, so please make sure you take time to do a lot of coloring, because the more detail you have on your picture, the better it will look. All right, so I found that a lot of details are good to use with just black pen afterwards. So you could use dots, lines, zigzags, waves. So go ahead and anywhere you want after you can use with black marker, you can add, you know, fun details. So you can see here, like, I did some waves, and over here I might do like a checker pattern over here or something. Anything that you think would make it more, you know, fun, you want to add those details. So however you want. Another way to add some of those details is with puff paint or glitter glue. Black almost just turns out just like your Sharpie, just so you know. So if you wanted to stand out, maybe you have pink glitter puff paint, or, you know, sometimes they have the fun ones in neon colors. Callie's got some glitter glue we thought we would try. So any of these add details, just make sure that you're able to leave it out to dry afterwards. And they have a pretty fine tip, so you can add it, you know, however you want, and then just let it rest overnight. So I'm gonna add a couple more details here with my puff paint.
I'm adding little lava whirlpools.
More lava whirlpools. Watch out for her lava, you guys. I'm afraid.
Well, Cat in the Hat should be more afraid.
So anything will work. You don't need to add too much, but it's kind of fun to add a little detail. This also gives...
Yeah. Also, if you do too much, like a glob, then just use the tip of it and, like, spread it.
Spread it out a little bit, yeah. The glitter glue...
The glitter glue can tend to come out really fast. Like, I kind of got some globs by accident. Dun, 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 dun. Okay. I'm going to switch to black because I have some really, really good ideas for that.
For black. Okay.
Or how so do you can open this?
Just right. Twist off.
Oh, there we go.
So you can see on here, hopefully, that you can see that I added some dots and lines, and it gives your picture a little bit more detail. Lastly, I hope that you are able to text me a picture of your final product. I will post it on Instagram every Friday, and I will also hold a Zoom meeting every Friday for about a half an hour between 11:30 and 12, where you can come in and we can all share our artwork and just touch base. It was fun being with you today. I hope you had a good time and that you took your time and you paused the video when needed. We'll see you next time. Bye!